how did the PSA know that there was a breach?
We know this on October 7 via a Facebook post that was posted by the netizen that allegedly has the files, the data files.
Okay, and in that initial post on Facebook, what was released on Facebook?
This was containing some links to a drive that contains CBMS files, and also some other links that may contain malware.
Okay, just how much data does the PSA believe was breached and what's released?
Yes, we are still configuring that out. We are still in the process of determining the extent of the downloaded data that was taken from our database. But this is basically one storage facility, Ms. Karen. So this is limited to the CBMS data.
Okay, when you say CBMS, can you speak in layman's terms? What kind of data is that?
Yes, the CBMS is the community-based monitoring system. This is a data collection of local government units. So this is on the local level, trying to collect data, or we are collecting data of respondents on the local level, so that our local government units has a way to analyze and to propose or implement policies.
Okay. Now, has there been a determination if the group that hacked PhilHealth is the same group that hacked PSA?
We cannot determine that yet, Ms. Karen, but we have some leads based on the Facebook posts.
Okay. But was Medusa ransomware also used to hack PSA?
Malicious file that was injected into our system. We don't think for now that is similar to the Medusa.
So you believe that the hacking, the malware that was used, wasn't the Medusa ransomware?
Yes, Ms. Karen.
Okay. All right. Now, moving forward, the group that actually hacked PhilHealth was asking for something like 300 million pesos, right? Now, has this group, did they communicate with PSA? Are they asking for, are they asking for blackmail money? Are they extorting?
As of now, Ms. Karen, there's no contact yet from the hackers. Asking for monetary consideration on the downloaded files.
So technically speaking, if nobody is asking for money and no group has communicated, has the PSA, do you have suspicions on what the motivation and the intention of the hacker was?
From the post that we have seen, it's just to expose or to brag about that they can do this kind of cyber attacks. We have coordinated with our law enforcement, like the anti-cybercrime group of NBI and PNP, and they are looking into the angle of all sorts of angle for the purpose of these hackers, for the purpose of using the data that they have got.
Okay, so far it's to brag that they're able to do it. So the question is, why are they able to do it? What kind of software or data protection does the PSA use?
Yes, we have firewalls that we employ in our systems, but I think there are the hackers have seen some vulnerabilities, and we have determined that for now, and the IT team of the PSA has already isolated this affected database. This is the network attached storage system of particularly for the CBMS. So we have isolated that, and we have turned down temporarily the system that is catering CBMS.
Okay, all right. Now, is it only CBMS? If I mean the national ID system, for example, that would be under the PSA, correct?
Yes, that's correct, Ms. Karen.
Okay, and has that been breached? Is that another department altogether, another system?
Yes, Ms. Karen, we are confident that the PhilSys or the national ID, as well as the civil registration databases, are not affected by this attack. This databases and all other databases that is connected with the services of the PSA is not connected with the PhilSys and in the civil registration services.
But after the attack on the CBMS, did the PSA did you tighten the firewalls or security of the other systems?
Yes, and in fact, Ms. Karen, we have already monitored even the non-affected. We have already monitored it. We have scanned it for some malicious activities, we are employing right now additional security measures on all our systems.
Okay, but what kind of data is in the you call it CBMS? So it's community-based
monitoring system.
Yeah. What kind of data is there? Like, are those names, addresses, birthdays? What are they? And who are they?
Yes. There are some, there are demographic information in the CBMS. There are educational information. We have also collected financial characteristics, not necessarily connected to an amount, and some others.
Okay, how would you describe the data that was hacked? Would they be confidential? Would they be relatively public? They're public? What are they?
For the demographic information, certainly these are confidential.
Okay. Pero wala naman dung specific finances. I mean, related to the person.
Yes, Ms. Karen. For the CBMS, it's not as extensive the financial information. That's not extensive as the other surveys of the PSA. We collect non-income related characteristics relating to financial status of our respondents.
Okay, all right. So what is the plan today? I mean, the DICT, for example, the lower house, the small committee in the lower house has decided to remove confidential and intelligence funds from certain agencies and move them to protecting the West Philippine Sea. But what's, I mean, at least you have the secretary stating that the DICT should have confidential and intelligence funds, given that you are experiencing cyber attacks. What are your thoughts?
Yes, Ms. Karen, we appreciate that
Secretary
would propose that there are some confidential funds because this kind of attacks, cyber attacks in particular, are a national concern, and the DICT as our guardian of our data, especially confidential data, is very much helpful in us protecting our data.
Okay, now would services be affected because of the breach? For example, narinig natin yung kumukuha ng birth certificate. Apektado ba yun?
Hindi po apektado ang operations ng civil registration services po natin. Makakakuha pa rin po ang mga kababayan natin ng kanilang mga birth certificate, mga marriage certificate, at mga death certificate. Ang national ID po, hindi rin po apektado, so tuloy-tuloy pa rin po ang operations.
Okay. Ang tanong ko sa national ID, maiba lang tayo sandali. What is with the delay? For example, I don't think I have my official national ID yet. Mine is laminated at this point. I haven't received the actual ID. And it's been, I would have to say, maybe 2 years.
Yes, we have been experiencing some delays. I understand, Ms. Karen, on the issuance of the physical ID. However, we have some venues also, or we have some other forms of the physical ID. We have the e-fill ID. This is downloadable fill ID.
What's the problem? What's the problem? That's the point. There's but my budget. Anong problema?
Yes, we are experiencing some delays in the printing and also in the logistics, well, the delivery of the fill ID.
Until now that the world is open, I mean, even now.
Yes, well, because primarily because we have backlogs before and we are catching up. But we assure that that we are doing something to catch up on the backlogs on the delivery, printing and delivery of the fill ID.
So let's get the latest on that, the record. How many Filipinos actually registered for a national ID?
Well, I don't have the exact data on that, but it's more than 80 million Filipinos are
All right,
registered.
more than 80 million Filipinos, more or less, how many physical IDs have you delivered?
Also, I don't have data on that,
But
but
would you know the backlog?
it's in the millions. But I think I'm not the right person to answer that, Ms. Karen. But it's in the millions.
Okay, but then what's the de do you have a timetable?
Yes, definitely we have a timetable, and we are exploring some other ways. So that somehow we can deliver either the physical fill ID, the e-fill ID, and the digital fill ID. By the way, Ms. Karen, the DICT has already launched the digital ID, I think, under the egov.ph.
All right. Anything you'd like to add to those who have business with the Philippine Statistics Authority?
Yes, Ms. Karen, we would like to assure the general public that we have already isolated the CBMS data sets and databases that was affected. We have already contained, and we have employed additional security measures, and we will continue to employ security measures in all aspects, technical, organizational, and physical security measures under our systems. And also we would like to assure the public that the PhilSES or the National ID and the Civil Registration Services is not affected by this. So the confidence is still there in securing the data for these two services. And also we would like to remind the public that if they come across the Facebook post containing the links of the supposed PSA data, please do not click on these links, because this may have malware which may compromise your gadgets, your devices, and also your accounts.
All right, on that note, I want to thank you so much, Attorney Eliezer Ambatali of the Philippine Statistics Authority. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Karen.